Okay, our mold has been cleaned and prepped and ready to go. So now what we need to do is add a mold release to this. What I'm going to use is this. It's GM foam mold release. This is the mold release that they use in foam latex. This has not been contaminated with the foam latex, because if it has, if you expose silicone to any kind of an ammonia-based product, it inhibits it from setting, and it can remain sticky and different problems. So this has not been contaminated with the GM foam products. This is just a mold release. It's a really nice mold release that we're going to be using for this mold instead of using those other types. So get it on your brush and then just coat the entire mold with it. It's going to be very difficult to get it inside these cracks. Try your best to get it as deep in the crevices and the cracks of this mold as you can. And coat the entire mold, because we want it to be able to remove. And this stuff kind of dries into like a powderish kind of stuff, which is pretty cool. So I used a paper towel and cleaned off the brush a bit. So now I can kind of get all the loose stuff that's just floating around on here. Now this mold is ready to go. There are two types of baldies on the market. There's an acetone base and an alcohol base baldies. Super baldies is the alcohol base. Regular baldies is the acetone base. This stuff was originally used for, and still is used for, making bald caps. You coat them on a form, and when it dries, you peel it off and you have a bald cap. The difference between these two is this one, when you're dissolving edges of your bald cap or a prosthetic that you've made, you use 99% isopropyl alcohol. This, you have to use acetone to dissolve it. Okay, I've taken my super baldies. I mixed it with 99% isopropyl alcohol. This is almost a 5-to-1 mixture, 5 parts 99% isopropyl to 1 part super baldies. This is what I'm going to spray on my mold. I found that if I paint it in my mold with a brush, that it bites really bad into it, and there's no way you can pull out without destroying your fine feathered edge, as you can see here. I pulled this one out and it just stuck really bad. So I called up a friend who is a makeup effects artist, and he said to spray it in lightly. I painted in my GM foam mold release. That's why it looks kind of frothy white on it. And I let it dry. And now I'm going to take my epoxy parafilm and I'm going to coat it really well so that I can make sure that it has a nice even coat. And I'm going to let this dry. Now I'm going to take my Super Baldies mixture, which is 1 part Super Baldies, 5 parts isopropyl alcohol, 99 proof. I'm going to squirt that on here as soon as this epoxy parafilm dries. Okay, now I'm going to spray this on. Make sure it's mixed really well. I'm going to spray from a distance because I kind of wanted to... What happens when you spray it, it actually turns into a web almost sometimes, depending on you know, how fine the mist is. So I'm going to go a little bit away and just kind of let it land on it. I'm going to let it dry and do 3 to 5 coats. What I'm going to make my prosthetic with is this Plaxil Gel 10. This is part A and B, and I'm using this Smith's Theatrical Prosthetic Deadener with this prosthetic silicone. The reason is what it does is it makes it real supple and soft and very pliable, not stiff like normal silicone. Also, pigments I'll be using is a flesh tone. This is light flesh and a blue and a yellow. That's what I use for to match up the person's skin tone that I'll be working with. All right, I'm ready to mix. First of all, what I recommend is you always label your containers that you're putting your chemicals in. Reason is so you don't end up using 2 A's or 2 B's or something. So I've marked each container so I know what I'm putting in it. Since I'm doing a small prosthetic and I'm only making one for this purpose, I'm going to use a small amount. If you plan on using a lot of chemicals, if you plan on making multiple prosthetics, then you would definitely want to make a larger batch. Okay, I'm doing 20 grams of both A and B.
Also, what I like to do is mark my stick and also put a dot on the bottom. And my deadener. Now let's add some color to our silicone. First of all, I start off with the flesh color. These are specially designed just for prosthetics. You can purchase them at the same place that you purchase your Plaxil Gel 10 or 00. There's all different types of silicone. Just read where you can purchase your Plaxil Gel 10. So, first of all, I mix a little bit into it. You cannot add this now to this one. Just because you have A, you can't mix it into B. You'll start contaminating it. So you set it aside. Grab a new toothpick. Just takes a little bit, not a lot, to mix this stuff. Okay, and then I also do the deadener. That little black dot you put at the end of your stick will tell you how well you mixed it. If it's too thick or not, you'll know. What you want to look for is, as it runs, you can see the little black dot showing, which means that that's a pretty good mixture. It's still translucent enough that you can actually use it. And if you find that you added too much, then you would just take your deadener and probably not add any color to it. Now I'm going to add a touch of blue. And what I mean by a touch of blue is I'm talking a dot. Just a dot of blue. Now I'm going to use the other end of my stick for that one. Like I say, it doesn't take a lot to color it. And you stir it in and it just takes it down just enough. That looks good too. Okay, now I'm gonna take my yellow, just add a touch. Just add a touch. Just add a touch. Stir that in. That will give me the skin tone that I desire. Also, to make it look a little bit fleshy, I like to add a little bit of flock to each. And stir the flock in. And that will actually redden it up a little bit. Just give it that little bit of a pink, fleshy feel. Now we are ready to mix up our prosthetic. So we're going to start off with part A, and I am going to do approximately 8 grams part A, 8 grams of part B, and I'm also going to do 8 grams of deadener. You can actually almost double your deadener if you want, but just too much of it will just make it too floppy and it won't hold up any form. Probably 7 grams of deadener, because I want it to still be supple, but I also want to be able to sew it and not have it be too supple that it just doesn't look too natural. So now I'm going to mix it all together. Mix it really well. Depending on the temperature of the room you're in, you have about a 6 minute work time with this. And then you're gonna pour it in kind of high. So I'm gonna go out of camera right now and I'm gonna just drizzle it in. And what it does is it pops all the bubbles so that I can just slowly pour it into the mold. And I'm going across it like this and going around it. I want it to just seep in. Now that your silicone is poured in, you want to take some kind of a hard plastic. You can use a putty knife if you want, and you just want to go across it like that. And I'm going to go across it one way and cross it another, just so I can get a really clean edge here. And what I'm also doing is, if you notice, it's filling that well, that little moat that I made around it. And it's leaving this fine edge here really, really thin. And before it sets, I like to take a Q-tip and actually wipe across this just gently, just so you can make sure that you've gotten all your silicone off of it. Because remember, this is going to be your feathered edge. You're going to blend this away into the actor's skin. So now I'm going to let this sit and cure. And once it's cured, then we're going to add another coat of Baldi's alcohol mix. And then that will encapsulate the silicone. And this is called a encapsulated prosthetic, because you have the Baldi's coating it, which is the top surface, and then you're also going to put Baldi's on the bottom, so you'll encapsulate the silicone, which will be called an encapsulated prosthetic. Now we're going to let this cure. If you notice, once it sets, it's still a little sticky, and that's because the deadener makes it sticky. So what we're going to do is we're going to encapsulate it now with our super Baldi's. We're going to add at least 3 coats to our prosthetic piece and let it dry, and then we'll remove it. All right, our encapsulating material is dry. It's not sticky anymore. I've got about 4 coats on it. So now I'm going to powder it. And as I peel it away, I will continually powder it, just so none of the areas stick to itself. So now this is the delicate part, is taking this thing apart. So what I do is I try and find a surface that I can grab onto. As you can see, it peels up. Actually peels up pretty well. First of all, I'm going to take it all away from the edges. Just go around it like this, and just get it away from the edge. And as I do this, I want to powder it. This just cuts the edge so that I can lift it away easier. All right, got it away from the edges. I'm going to go ahead and powder a little bit, just a little bit of powder. Now I'm going to dig in here. Try and peel up this lip here. Doesn't always want to come up because it kind of bites into the center a little bit. But now I'm going around and I'm peeling up this lip. I'm just pulling it away from the edge because deep inside it sticks. Just like that. Nice and gently. Okay, so I've got the whole surface all the way around. Really nice. Now I'm going to pull out my prosthetic. Now I have a lot of stuff for it to bite onto, so I'm just being super gentle to hopefully get my entire piece out without too many bad tears. So I'm slowly digging it out just ever so carefully. Just because I want to keep this whole piece intact as much as I can. Even with all of my mold release, I'm still going to have places where it grabs because of all my sharp returns and detail. It's going to grab it. So I'm just trying my best to be very careful. And even if it tears it, I'm hoping that it will look good still because it is a wound. This is a beautiful edge here. This will dissolve right into the skin with the 99% isopropyl alcohol. I've got some stretching and sticking a little bit, I noticed, on the edge here from me pulling on it. So hopefully I'll be able to stretch that out and keep the edge nice and clean. But that's my piece right there. And what you want to do is you want to attach the middle first. As you touch it to it, It just pulls it away. It's super fine edge and it dissolves right into your skin really nice. And I'm going to start coloring this up.
Eggehead